Hey there, baseball fans, and welcome into the Catch at Las Vegas Ballpark. As always, I'm your host, Matt Neverett, coming to you today from our camera well, above home plate, above the suite level. A perfect backdrop today as well as our staff gets prepared for the Battle for Vegas, our yearly charity softball game between players from the Raiders and the Golden Knights, taking place right here at Las Vegas Ballpark. The Aviators just wrapped up a six-game series, welcoming in division foe Salt Lake for a six-game set here at the ballpark. With the Aviators featuring a giveaway on Friday night, a free trucker hat sponsored by our friends at Cox, and the best giveaway of the year so far, the free Aviators jersey sponsored by Steiners on Saturday night. In the opening inning of the opening game, Christian Pache jumped Los Reyes de Plata ahead on Tuesday night with his first home run since joining Las Vegas, a two-run shot that jump-started the home offense. Later on in the frame, Matt Davidson also scored Billy McKinney on an RBI base hit to cap off a three-run inning to start the game. Colin Wiles turned in another strong outing on the mound, firing through six innings for the fifth straight start and earned his team-leading seventh win of the year in another quality start that featured no walks, just three runs and four strikeouts, including a strike-em-out, throw-em-out, twin-killing that wrapped up the fourth inning. After Salt Lake plated three runs in the first three innings to tie the score, Max Schumann homered to right in the fourth, a two-run shot in his first game with Las Vegas in 2022, but the offense was far from done in the fourth inning.
He swings, hammers this one. You can forget about it. A ball to left center field for Shea Langeliers. Kiss it goodbye. Second long ball of the inning, and the Aviators now lead 7-3.
After the two-run blast from Shea Langeliers, Vince Fernandez went back-to-back with the Athletics' number one prospect on his 11th dinger of the year, extending the outfielder's streak to six straight games with an extra base hit. After the other newcomer, Cal Stevenson, singled and stole second in the fifth, the final two tallies thrown up by the home team were off the bat of Billy McKinney, who scored Stevenson and Max Schumann on an RBI single. And while it would be the final hit of the night for Los Reyes de Plata, good outings out of the bullpen from Jorge Ruiz and Ryan Castellani were aided by some stellar defense down the stretch to claim a 10-4 victory in the 48th win of the season for Las Vegas, who moved to 12 games over 500 and remained all alone in first place in the Pacific Coast League West. After four straight losses to Salt Lake following the Tuesday victory, it was up to Colin Wiles and the Aviators pitching staff to pick up the struggling offense on Sunday. Wiles, however, did what he usually does, turn in a strong outing and give his team a chance to win on the hill. The only run allowed by Las Vegas on Sunday was a solo home run to Salt Lake catcher Matt Theis in the second inning, and it would take until the seventh before the Aviators scored anything. With Max Schumann on second base, Mickey McDonald legged out an infield single to set up Jonah Bry with two out and two on.
He swings, drives one in the air to right, going back to the track is Thomas. He's at the wall, he looks up and it is gone! Kiss it goodbye, a three-run bomb from Jonah Bry. And the Aviators, with their first run since Friday, now lead 3-1 in the bottom of the seventh inning.
The bats did not wait long to reactivate, with Austin Allen singling and Billy McKinney reaching on a rare bunt base hit in the eighth inning to set up newcomer Cal Stevenson, who launched his first home run since being traded from the Rays organization in a deal involving Christian Bethencourt. The second three-run home run in as many innings gave the Aviators bullpen all the support they would need. It was David McKay, Sam Selman, and Garrett Acton combining to blank the bees with no runs or even hits allowed after the fifth inning. Acton closed the game with a strong six-out save, and the 49th win of the year pushed the Aviators a half a game over Reno atop the PCL's Western Division standings heading into the All-Star break. And while the Las Vegas Aviators were busy winning the first and final games against Salt Lake, catcher Shea Langeliers was busy not only playing in the All-Star Futures game in Los Angeles, but dominating the field of Major League Baseball's top prospects. Langeliers clubbed a solo home run in the showcase and threw a base runner out as well, something he's done four prior times with the Aviators in the same game so far this season. The Athletics' number one overall prospect was dubbed as the game's most valuable player, an award given out by the kid Ken Griffey Jr. himself, as Shea's dominant first season in the Athletics organization just got one trophy heavier. A big congratulations to Shea as well as Denzel Clark, the other representative from the Athletics at the MLB All-Star Futures game in Los Angeles. That'll do it for this episode of The Catch here at Las Vegas Ballpark. Follow all things Aviators at Aviators LV on social media. After nine games on the road following the All-Star break, Las Vegas returns home on August 2nd to take on in-state rival Reno in a six-game series. Get your tickets now at aviatorslv.com or thelvballpark.com. I'm Matt Neverett saying thanks so much for joining us. Thanks for having a catch.